Before you start researching, shape your topic into a complete sentence. This is a standard practice for upper-level research in many fields, and one of the most helpful things you can do to prepare to search a database. Writing out your topic as a complete sentence does three things for you. It forces you to get focused before you start searching. It provides you with thoughtful words to begin searching. And it will help you if you get stuck in the middle of searching. Go ahead and write out a sentence, even if it's not great. If the goal of your research is to answer a question, write it out as a question. If you're preparing for a paper where you argue for or against something, write it out as a statement. This is not a perfect statement, but we'll leave it like it is for now. Maybe we'll come up with some better phrasing as we work more with the topic. Now, go back and underline words in the sentence that are the main concepts. You should have at least two and probably not more than four. Make a column for each of the major concepts in your research sentence. Set a timer on your phone for 5 minutes and begin brainstorming synonyms for each of these concepts. Try to imagine words that someone else might use when writing about these subjects. When you're done, you'll have something that looks like this. Maybe as a result of your brainstorming, you decided that negative effect sounds better than bad, and maybe adolescence sounds more professional than teenagers. And now our research statement looks a little better. Now you're ready to jump in and search. The goal when you're searching a database is to see your research statement reflected in your choice of search words. One of the most common mistakes researchers make is to forget to have all of the main ideas from your research sentence reflected up in these search boxes. It would be really easy to sort of space out and just type social media. You could spend hours sifting through the results trying to find the ones that have to do with teenagers and mental health. In this case, you'd actually be better off typing your whole search sentence into one box like your grandma searches Google and praying for the algorithm to be kind to you. No offense to your grandma, you can do this and you may get a few good hits. Maybe a few is all you need. Maybe not. Either way, you're going to miss some really good articles and there are still way too many results. As you look through your results, you may discover that other researchers are using words and phrases that you hadn't thought of. Maybe social media use makes more sense in your research sentence than just social media. Maybe you see the word excessive and realize that that sounds better than too much. As you sift through your results, add to your brainstorming list words that researchers are using to describe your topic, and use those words when you search a second, third, or fourth time. As a result of learning more about this field of study, your research question could go from too much social media is bad for the mental health of teenagers to excessive use of social media has a negative effect on the mental health of adolescents. Welcome to academia. Your goal is not to create a fancy research sentence. Your goal is to identify the main ideas in your research sentence and to see them reflected in your search terms. If you're unhappy with your search results, return to your research question and search with some of your brainstormed words. Now that you can draw on a bank of terms that covers all aspects of your topic, watch the video on advanced searches and Boolean operators next. You can follow a link in the description of this video.